Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Dr. Himanshu Gupta and in this video I'm going to discuss with you how you can study and learn anything better and retain it for a longer period of time. What is the basic funda behind learning? Friends, I was a very weak student during my MBBS days. So when I was preparing for NEET PG entrance examination, I analyzed myself where I was going wrong during my MBBS days. What I used to do that I used to read things with interest, then I used to throw that book away. I never used to read that thing again and again. I decided that during my preparation, whatever I will read, I will read it many times. I had this fear of not remembering anything. So I made it a habit that whatever I will read it within a span of 1 week, or then after a period of 1 month, and again after a period of 2 months. One thing that you have to take from today is that repetition is the only way to learn things. There is no other way. You form n number of mnemonics. Even if you don't repeat the mnemonics again and again, you will forget the mnemonic also. Even if you have a visual memory of something, even if you don't recall that visual memory again and again, you will not even have that visual memory also. Friends, I did this mistake throughout my MBBS. So I want you guys that you don't commit this mistake. Friends, I talk to students and I ask them that how is your preparation is going. They say that mujhe to kuch yaad hi nahi hai. I don't remember anything. Then I ask them, when did you read that thing? When did you read pharmacology? They say that I read it 2 months back, 3 months back. So if you have read anything 3 months back, 2 months back, how can you remember it? You have to revise all that you read. I don't know how you manage. You have to manage if you have to learn. So whatever you read, you try to read it again and again. Whatever you read it today, try to read it tomorrow, then after 1 week, then after 15 days, then after 1 month. This is the only way to learn things. Suppose like doing the same thing is very boring. You can make it interesting by discussing what you have read with your friend. If you don't want to read theory, you can do the MCQs of the same topic that you have read. 1 week later, it will be a revision in another form, or you can teach it to your friends. So this way you can repeat things. Friends, during my preparation, I devised another way with which I can revise things very easily, and I call it by the wall technique. In the wall technique, what you have to do is that whatever you are reading, you find some important tables, important charts, organisms, important declarations, the color of the various cylinders used in anesthesia, the porphyria cycle. You write them on a page and you paste it on your wall. Whenever you are, if you are reading for 8 hours daily or 10 hours daily, try to make at least 5 to 10 sticky notes and make it a habit that you paste them on the wall of your room, on the wall of your study table, wherever you can read it comfortably. So if you do around 10 sticky notes daily, in 100 days you will be able to make around 1000 sticky notes. I repeat again, in 100 days you will be able to make 1000 sticky notes, and these sticky notes you have to read it after getting up in the morning and before going to sleep. You have to eat your breakfast, lunch, dinner in front of those sticky notes. If you are reading something so many times, you will automatically remember it. Imagine going into the AIIMS exam by having those 500 to 1000 sticky notes read around 20 to 30 times. Imagine the confidence you will get. You will be at a different level. So try doing this thing from today only. 5 to 10 sticky notes daily. Suppose you are reading anesthesia today. Okay, you write the color of the cylinders on a one sticky note, then you write the sizes of the LMA, then you write the ASA grading, then you write the drugs which are contraindicated in epilepsy or which are used in neurosurgery, which are used in liver failure. Make a list of all the important things. It will just take you around 20 to 30 minutes. And then paste it on the wall. Read it before going to bed, after getting up in the morning. You will definitely, in 10 days, definitely you will see the change. Follow this thing for 10 days and see how easily you are able to remember things. Suppose you have pasted the anti-diabetic drugs. What are GLP-1 analogs? What are DPP-4 antagonists? You are reading them daily for 10 days. There is no way that you are not able to remember it. Okay friends, so try following this wall technique, and behind you can see the image of the wall that I myself made. I used to paste around 5 to 10 sticky notes daily, and I used to read them whenever I was getting free time. Around 20 to 30 questions used to come from the grand test. Even in the NEET exam, around 20 questions came from the wall that I had made. If you are reading in the library, you can make your wall in the room of your hostel or wherever you are staying. You can keep two A4 size sheets with you. You can write the whole things. You can write down the things while you are studying, and when you go back to your room, you paste them. And if you are comfortable with pasting the thing in the library itself, then it's good. Friends, now I will discuss some other ways to learn things. Other ways is understanding the things. Friends, if you understand the things, it is very easy to remember them. Suppose you have to learn the ECG of atrial fibrillation. In atrial fibrillation, we don't get P wave. But for that, you have to remember that in atrial fibrillation, there is no P wave. How you will remember it? You have to understand in atrial fibrillation, the atria are not contracting. So you will not get the P wave. In ARDS type 1, you don't have to learn that PO2 levels decreases, the PCO2 level decreases. You have to understand. You have to understand that in ARDS type 1, there is problem in absorption of oxygen. That is why the oxygen levels are low. And if oxygen is not being absorbed, so how will the carbon dioxide be produced? Second way of learning this is making mnemonics. So in micro, we have to learn that what are the viruses which are naked. So there is a mnemonic. Give pap smears and CPR to a naked hippie virus. So this way I learned which are the naked virus. PAP is for DNA virus and CPR is for RNA viruses. So you in pharmacology, you will find so many mnemonics. Like you have to learn that aminoglycosides and tetracyclines act on 30S ribosome. So how do you remember it? Cell at 30, buy at 50. So this was the mnemonic, and this way I was able to remember that aminoglycosides and tetracyclines act on 30S ribosome. Third, friends, I will tell you one thing that I learned from some book, that what kind of things you are able to learn. You are able to learn those things that are interesting. What we have to do is that whatever we are reading or learning, we have to be curious. We have to love that thing. Once we are able to love and be curious about that thing, we will be automatically able to learn that thing. In order to learn anything, you have to know why you are learning that thing. I will share you one experience with me. Friends, when I was learning DAMS notes and other MC and other textbooks that I was reading, I was not able to learn them. Why? Because I was not understanding the importance. But once I started doing the previous year questions, I realized that this thing is being asked in the exam. So when I know that this question, this fact can be asked in the exam, I realize that its importance. I realize that I have to learn that thing. So that's why you have to do previous year questions. Once you will do previous year questions, you will see the topics that are being asked in the exam, and then you will come back to your notes. You will be able to learn them better because you know this question will be asked in the AIIMS exam. This question can be asked in PGI exam or in the NEET exam. So friend, this was all about how you can learn anything better and faster. I will again summarize what I had said in this video. Repetition, understanding, mnemonics. But repetition is the first key. If you are not repeating anything, then even what you understand, what mnemonics you make, you will forget them. Lastly friends, I have a page by the name Purpose on Facebook where I give tips and suggestions for students who are preparing for